Every year, thousands of Christians from within and out of the country travel to Namgongo to participate in the annual Martyrs' Day celebrations. A big number of these are usually foot pilgrims who trek in groups to Namgongo. Police have today issued guidelines for those walking to Namgongo to ensure their safety through their pilgrimages. Walking at night and very early in the morning has been prohibited.
We've had tragic incidents where pilgrims wake up very early as 4:30 in the morning under the cover of darkness, and some of them have been knocked dead. Then even those who move late at 10 p.m., you would also find them facing challenges. So we have restricted that movement under the cover of darkness. Christians who have made the spiritual journey before, the weather is unpredictable, so we encourage them to carry warm clothing, have their IDs, mobile phones. Those who can put on reflector jackets can put them on. Light bags. Sometimes in the past we've seen pilgrims carrying very heavy luggages as if they're migrating. You just need a few things just that can really help you. They should also ensure that they have transport money.
Police have also instructed all their territorial commanders to provide security to the pilgrims as they walk through the different parts of the country.
Pilgrims who have started moving from Kanungu, Lira, we have the ones from Gulu, all these are being protected by the police and sister security agencies. So far, no incidents of crime and safety have been registered. And so the IGP directed all territorial commanders to ensure the safety and security of these pilgrims by escorting them and providing protection to them while sleeping at churches, at schools and community centers.
Over 100 pilgrims have embarked on their journeys from different parts of the country so far, heading to Namgongo for the Martyrs' Day celebrations. Meanwhile, the police have launched inquiries into anonymous letters sent to several legislators by a group of people claiming to be part of the disgruntled officers. According to the police, these have been threatening the lives of several legislators. Police have urged the legislators to stay alert.
Joint security agencies acknowledged receipt of an anonymous letter that is attributed to Association of Tired Officers in Uniform. They call themselves ATOA. This letter was posted to the District Woman MP, Mityana District, Honorable Bagala, with threats to life, and where she was given conditions of either paying 10 million within 3 days from the 20th, so which means it has even expired to the 23rd. So failure of which would take 4 bullets from this association, this alleged association. Now, this association claims that it comprises of army and police officers who have decided to handle matters on their own, and they have threatened parliament and other lawmakers to either handle their matters. The matters which they are talking about is recognize their service by improving their working environment, welfare, and increase their pay. And they warned that failure to do so, that if the lawmakers fail to handle their matters, they will stop leaving.
Relatedly, police are working with other security agencies to counter increased cases of gun violence in the country. Since the beginning of this month, at least 10 shooting incidents have been recorded in different parts of the country, and these have claimed several lives, including that of a minister.
Facing the aggressive conduct of officers or security guards, private security guards, of course, remains a priority. We are working with other security agencies and partners like private security organizations, the leadership and associations of private security organizations, to ensure that we have the right policies, intelligence, detection and enforcement. Gun violence had really reduced in the past until of recent, due to the intensive policing and stricter gun policy that we had. And however, this slight increase in these reckless types of shootings over petty conflicts and disputes shows that people are getting desperate.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.